What information should I provide when asking for help? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. I will freely admit that this article is 30% rant on my part and 70% my honestly really wanting to be able to help you. And to do that, I need you to help me. And this applies to actually whomever you're asking questions of, right? It doesn't matter if it's me. Whoever you're asking questions of when it comes to tech, they need the right information in order to be able to help you. I want to go over exactly what that means so that when you submit a question, again, wherever, the chances of your getting a useful answer or an answer at all is greater. Now, I do want to point out that everything depends. There is no magic formula. I can't tell you, I can't give you like a bullet list of always provide this information because the kinds of questions that you might be asking span a wide variety of topics, right? Your machine configuration may not matter if you're asking about a phone or if you're asking about an online service. And conversely, your machine configuration may matter dramatically if you're asking about how software is or is not misbehaving on your machine. So please use a little bit of discretion and think about what information honestly applies to the question you are asking. I will tell you one thing that absolutely does not help. And that is a question of the form, this something doesn't work. That tells me nothing. That tells me absolutely nothing about what's going on. And even though your question may not be X doesn't work, there are so many variations that boil down to exactly that, that I just can't help. Depending on the situation, my only choice may be to ignore the question, because otherwise the only alternative for me is to now invest the time in what is often a lengthy back and forth question and answer session to try and extract more information about exactly what's going on. So if you find your question is, this doesn't work, let's look at some of the questions that I, in turn, will ask you that you can provide from the beginning. For example, how does it not work? Tell me what happened. Tell me the exact error message, not just it said something like, no, the exact error message. Send me a screenshot if you can. That's a great way to avoid having to retype all of the error messages that you might be seeing. And to be clear, if you submit a question on askleo.com, yes, you won't be able to include an image, but you will get an auto response via email, and you can then respond to that automated response with your image as an attachment. Tell me exactly what went wrong. What were you expecting? In other words, how did whatever happened not match your expectations? It's not always obvious to me what success really means to you, so it's important for me to understand exactly what it was you were expecting so that we can basically judge the difference between what happened and what you wanted. What exact steps did you take to get the problem? I realize not every problem can be replicated by following a specific set of steps, but so many can. Tell me the exact detailed steps that you took to get the problem you're experiencing. Another way to look at it is, okay, how would I make this problem happen on my machine? Tell me how to do that. That helps a lot. What kinds of things have you tried? Usually people come to me and to others doing what I do almost as a last resort, right? They've tried a lot of things. And that's great. That's wonderful because honestly, in trying a lot of things, there's often a good chance that you will in fact solve the problem yourself. Fantastic. However, When you finally run out of things to try and you come to me, it's really important that I understand the kinds of things you've already done so that we don't end up reinventing the wheel. I just got a question the other day where it said, I tried all the things you find on the internet. I don't know what that means. I don't know what you tried. Tell me specifically, what are the various things that you've tried so that we know not to waste your time trying them again? Has anything changed recently? Most often, people understand that change often is the harbinger of problems, right? But sometimes they don't. They don't understand that, you know what, I changed this thing over here, and now all of a sudden that thing over there stopped working. They don't realize that there's a connection. And to be fair, connections aren't always obvious. But if there is something that has changed about your setup, about your machine, about your usage, whatever, include that information. Sometimes it can be very, very valuable to help direct exactly where we start looking for the problem. Yes, of course. Tell me about your system. This is the one that, honestly, it's an easy one to solve. People generally will give this information. But again, knowing which version of Windows you're using. Are you even using Windows? What kind of machine are you running? What's the operating system? What's the version of the operating system? What browser are you running when you're reporting a problem with a website? What is the manufacturer of your computer? What's its make and model? How much RAM do you have? How big is the hard disk? Any additional hardware that might even be vaguely related to the issue at hand. These are all pieces of information that are very easy to get, very easy to provide, and can sometimes, again, jumpstart the ability for people such as myself to give you a more accurate and more useful answer. There are a couple of tools, actually, that can really help. Speccy is one from Piriform, the makers of CCleaner, that, again, just displays your specs. It's the specs of your machine, and it has the ability to save that as a file. Similarly, the screenshot of your system properties after you right-click on the Start button and click on the System will provide a fair amount of detail about your Windows system. And there are other tools that we might point you at as a second step to get even deeper. But that, at a minimum, tells me what version of Windows you're running, how old it is, and whether it's up to date. So these are the kinds of things that really honestly help a lot when I'm about to try and answer a question that you might provide. The most important thing is ask yourself some of these questions above. You may find that actually thinking about those questions may actually make an answer self-evident. You may not need me anymore, and that's fine. That's great. But when you do ask your questions, when you do have a problem that you are asking for help on, and again, it doesn't have to be me. It can be an open forum. It can be another service. It can be whatever. Be as clear and as complete as you are able to be. I know you may not know what's important. I get that. But there's a lot of information that you probably can provide, and doing so will help me to help you. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, please visit askleo.com/30545. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.